meteorologist Jason Brewer in now and just kind of looking at the maps, and it's just Midwest kind of getting hammered.
It's an amazing storm, and it really looks like what a hurricane would look like.
That's what they're saying, hurricane force winds.
I mean, it's just incredible. So this storm indirectly bringing us a little bit of wind today. The pressure difference between the big storm up there in Minnesota, in fact, I just saw on Twitter, strongest storm in Minnesota history.
Wow.
So yeah, this is just one to watch here through the afternoon. It's going to lift out to the north during the day tomorrow, and so the winds will relax a little more around here. But the difference between the high out to the east and the low to the north, we're getting a little breeze, and we're also seeing a couple of isolated showers crop up right along 95 here as they race to the north. There's Titusville, so just on the north side of town up toward Oak Hill, a little quick downpour over the next 10, 20 minutes. And FutureScan does a pretty good job showing a few more of these showers through 5 o'clock, and then watch what happens through about 8, 9 o'clock. A couple of more showers developing with our west coast breeze trying to merge here, possibly in a similar location to where we saw last night, Lake County, northwest Volusia to Flagler, eastern Marion. That could be the corridor where we see a couple of heavier downpours crop up through the late evening hours. And then in the morning, we wake up with a stray shower possible along our coastline. But we got enough rain yesterday to break the dry streak officially at Daytona Beach and Melbourne, and rather Leesburg, but Melbourne and Orlando, you were still in it. So Melbourne, 3 more days without rain. We tie the all-time record for consecutive dry days on the books. Hopefully, we don't get to that and we get a couple of downpours out there for you. Only a 20% rain chance, though, overall, not only today, but on into the middle part of the week here. Temperatures right now are warm and muggy, mid-80s most spots, a couple of upper 80s. Showing you the dew points because they are almost like summer with a lot of low 70s out there. Feels pretty muggy, and you got those wind gusts transporting that moisture up out of the south at around 20, 25 miles an hour. High temperatures, upper 80s at the coast, near 90 inland. Our average is 83, so we're up closer to record territory. In fact, Daytona Beach, I think you could even break a record today. If you get up to 89, your record's 88. So 6:45, our sunset, and we'll slowly drop the temperatures after that, but not much. Look at this, 7 o'clock, we're still hanging around 81 degrees. Now to the tropics real quickly, because Richard, our 17th named storm, now just a remnant low. Regeneration down here in the Gulf is not a concern because of the dry air and the wind shear over the top of this system. Here's the last advisory for you. And we also have this one system way out over the Atlantic to keep tabs on. It's moving to the north, but it does have a slight chance to develop in the coming days. All right, so through Thursday, near record highs, that's a big story, isolated rain chances. Then by Friday, we are seeing drier air move in, and your Halloween weekend outlook looking pretty nice. We should see low 80s and overnight lows back in the upper 50s by Friday night. See, I'm